In movies and money, Universal Film Studios and AMC Theaters are making history with a new agreement. It used to take years, months, or even weeks for films to go from the big screen to the small screen. But now, films going into streaming are in fast-forward mode. Movie man Eric Childress is here to catch us up on all the drama of the deal. Hello, Eric.
Hi, Angie.
Well, some people are calling the deal a game changer for the industry. What do you think?
Potentially, Angie. The thing that initially stands out to me is that this is not just some short-term deal in the wake of a pandemic when fewer people are likely to be going out to theaters. This was announced as a multi-year arrangement between one of the biggest theater chains in the country going through some dire straits and the most financially consistent studio not named Disney over the last decade that they were planning to boycott. But before we get into where the tentacles of this deal could possibly stretch, let's look at what we do know so far. Films under the Universal and Focus Feature banner will now just have a 17-day theatrical window. That is down from what has been an industry standard of 90 days and meant that films could not hit home viewing of any kind for its first 3 months of release to give theaters an advantage to keep bringing in patrons. With that cut down to 17, Universal and AMC have agreed that after that time, those films can then go to a premium on-demand service offered by the theater chain. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean the films will leave theaters, but people can then choose to pay a fee and watch them at home at their leisure, the price of which is a detail which is really yet to emerge. But that is clearly a radical shift, and if you look at just Universal's films from 2019, anywhere from 65 to 92% of their theatrical revenue came in their first 17 days. 74 to 82% of the films that grossed over $100 million. Now remember, Universal saw a $100 million gross back in April when they released Trolls World Tour direct to streaming. So even with a slightly favorable split on those grosses with AMC, they're likely to make up whatever would have been contracting theaters to keep their films playing in the first place.
How quickly do you think other studios and theaters will begin to adopt this new arrangement?
Hard to say, Angie. Years down the road, we could be looking at this as the moment that everything changed in regards to how we analyze a film's financial success. But right now, I imagine there is a lot of scrambling going on. Disney already has their own subscription streaming service and could just as easily add a premium subscription or a pay-per-view for newer titles. Just last week, we were talking how the summer season officially went kaput when Warner Brothers pulled Tenet from the schedule, but only a week later, they announced a new distribution plan to release it internationally in locations where COVID is under control, and then put it in theaters in the U.S. over Labor Day weekend. Now, Christopher Nolan wants the film played in theaters, obviously, but you have to imagine they are making preparations when those numbers are likely not to be up to blockbuster standards. Now, other films may choose to just forego a theatrical launch altogether, as Bill and Ted Face the Music announced last week, though that would not have been the case if the coronavirus curve had truly flattened here. The bottom line right now is that all bets are off during the pandemic, but that doesn't mean that everything is also not on the table.
Thank you, Eric, for keeping tabs. We will see you back here next week.
Thank you, Angie.
More Business First AM. Check us out on social media. We're on Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter. And go to businessfirstam.com for where to see our show on TV.